Hello, Yugles. I am Stephen, and welcome to another Model Railway review. This one, not surprisingly, follows on pretty much from the one I did recently of the East Kent Railway Number 5 Adams Radial, because I did manage to go back to the shop not long after I filmed that. Got a couple of the other locos as well. One of them, obviously, in this video. Another one in the next coming video. I could only get two because my money was low. But anyway, less of the gossip. The other Adams that I've finally got, and believe me, it's not going to be the last one either, is this one. The Southern Railway liveried Adams. Pretty much as standard, like in all the other boxes. You've got like the ice cube packaging with the extra details in there. You've got the typical sort of box with the extra info inside. Oh, my voice broke then for a second then. And then, obviously, you've got the normal, typical packaging. And we all know what happens to these, don't we? Yes. Lives over there now. And here she is. Number 3520. This is the Adams radial tank that I mentioned in my previous East Kent Railway number 5 review. That this is the other member 488 joined on the line Regis branch. This is the other Adams radial that was already there, along with another sister, which I think is number 169. I can't remember. I'll have to double check it. If I was wrong about it, then I'll obviously state the actual number of the locomotive here. Now, this one has got a few differences between 488 and, well, obviously, this one. There are a few differences, excluding the livery, obviously, because this is in the Southern Railway, sort of like dark olive, sort of like monster livery. Actually, what did they depict it on the box? Just Adams Southern 3520. But it is a very, very gorgeous livery nonetheless. This one, this engine is actually depicted with the drum and boiler. You can always tell that because the safety valves have been moved from above the firebox here to through the dome. That's how you can always tell when an engine's got a drum and boiler, because the safety valves are more likely going to be through the dome. And you can see that through the Greyhound, the T9, the M7s as well. They've got safety valves through their dome. And also you've got the sort of like Drummond-style chimney or funnel, whatever you call it, from wherever you're from. And also, because the safety valves have moved, the whistles are more prominent. Now, I don't think I spotted this on my other models, but I never noticed that the Adams had two different styles of whistles, which seems to be, on this one, a high tone and a low tone. Whether this is something that this particular numbered member of the class had got remains a mystery. And something else as well is that, do you remember in my East Kent Railway 5 review about how I said about the coal rails being all like moulded see-through? Well, it turns out that I did some more digging again, but obviously the coal rails on this are sort of like solid again, pretty much like on the 488 model. So obviously they were just like the cab windows, the boilers, the funnels, the domes, etc. on the Adams radial, along with the actual front end of the actual locomotive itself, these bits here, which is actually part of the locomotive chassis as well, which at the front here, this, for those that don't know, the front end of this bit, specifically this bit on the locomotive on the Adams radial tank, that is actually known as a patio. So it's quite interesting to know that they've actually spotted that this version 3520, or this numbered member of the class, has actually got a different style of chassis. Got the inside detail as well. Very, very nice. Careful not to drop this one. I mean, that's a good shot right there.
Snapshot.
The other side of the cab. Come on, focus of the cab. Stop focusing on Southern. Actually getting a little bit more. There we go. Very, very nice. I really do love the Adams radial tanks. I really do. Yes. So, let's get this one on the rolling road. Alright, 3520 is on the rolling road. We all know the action here. Let's see how she performs straight out of the box. Crank up the power a bit. Yep, and just like her other members, very, very, very little power needed. Just after the second bar on the old style boxy Hallby controller, not the newest one. In case people are wondering what the actual old Hallby number of the controller I'm using is, it's actually R.965, I believe it says on the moulding of this. Yeah, R.965 is the old controller style I've got, which to me is the better one, because obviously, as I said in another video, compared with the newer one, which is just absolutely rubbish, and the fact that it's unreliable as anything, it's actually got a neutral position, whereas with the newer Hornby style one, because they wanted it to be upkeep with all the DCC and DC stuff, blah, 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 there's no neutral position, so I'm very, very, very sketchy about that, and I don't like it. Crank that up to the end of the second bar. And slow. And in the other direction. Yep. Only just started on the second bar. At the end of the second bar. Very, very nice. Yeah, that is the Oxford Rail Southern Railway livery to Adams Radial Class number 3520. If you guys want to see more videos like this, then please be sure to leave a like, subscribe for more content on my channel, and I'll see you all in the next video. Ta-ra, Yugles.